Good morning, children. Welcome back to math session. Today we are going to discuss about triangles, that is congruent triangles. Actually, what is congruent and everything we will know in this session. Okay, see now. In earlier class you have learned about triangles, right? Just name this triangle as ABC. Okay, ABC is a triangle, and you all know that AB, BC, CA are sides of a triangle, right? And angle A, angle B, angle C are called angles. And even A, comma B and C are vertices, and you are very much aware of vertices because only one, that means A individual, it is called, that means singular, A itself it is called vertex. So this vertices means it's a plural. Okay, children. Now the sum of all the sides of a triangle, that is nothing but AB plus BC plus CA. This is sum of all the sides, right? According to this figure, this is sum of all the sides. So sum of all the sides is nothing but perimeter. Okay, sum of all the sides of a triangle is called perimeter. And here the angles, here if you see clearly, A, B, C, that means angle A plus angle B plus angle C, that is sum of the three angles. So sum of the three angles of a triangle equals to 180 degrees. Okay, so basing on this triangle, we have six types of triangles. Okay, basing on this, there are six types of triangles, that is basing on magnitudes and sides. The six types of triangles are completely based on magnitudes and sides. Magnitudes means acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle, right angled triangle. And coming to sides, scalen, isosceles, and equilateral. Okay, equilateral triangle. Okay, now here they may ask you question like, one more, the sum of all the three sides of a triangle is 180, each angle measures how much? When it is a equilateral triangle, then each angle measures how much? 60 degrees. Okay, so this all we learned in earlier classes. Now today we are going to learn about what? Different types of properties. Different types of properties of triangles. Okay, so now we are going to learn about different types of properties of triangles. Okay, children? Okay, children? See here. Okay, now here what I told you, there are four types of properties of triangles. That is, the first one is side, side, side. And next, side, angle, side. And next, SAS. Okay, side, 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 angle, side. Next, right, hypotenuse, side. Okay, one more, that is angle, side, angle. That means in shortcut they are going to write S S S property, side 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 property, S A S, and this one A S A, and this one R H S. So this three first we will learn, and at last we'll go for right hypotenuse side. But before learning about these properties, the very important topic you have to learn, that is nothing but congruence. What is that? Congruence. What is that? Congruence means, actually, what is the exact meaning of congruence? Okay, now see here. Here, if you see in my hand, there is a book, right? If you clearly observe, there is a book with my hand. With the same book, with the same size and same shape, okay? The same book, if you take another book, suppose this is a 5th standard, some living math, something book. The same book, don't bother about the color and everything. Just the same book, otherwise any other book, but there should be same shape and same size. That means if you place any other book on this, or means overlap, they both should adjust according to their heights and the lengths and breadths. That means they should have same shape and same size. That means what is the exact meaning of congruency? Means two plane figures are said to be congruent. Okay, the two plane figures are said to be congruent. We can call it as congruent also. Two plane figures are said to be congruent. They should have same shape and same size. How? I am going to tell you here. See, here, if you take two triangles here, A, B, C, and one more triangle here, I have taken here, P, Q, R. This is only possible with comparing with two, okay? Two plane figures, okay? Suppose, here, in triangle, you can say, by these properties, like side, side, side property. What are these all? I am going to explain, because first of all, you should know what is the exact meaning of congruency, okay? How you have to say these two are congruent and everything, I am going to tell you, okay? So, triangles means you can say by using this property. But for this, it is very easy to tell you. But one more figure is there. Actually, it is not there. But sometimes they may ask you a general question like this. If two circles are given in this chapter only, they may ask you a simple question like this. How you can say that these two circles are congruent? Actually, what is the meaning of congruent means? Congruent means two plane figures are said to be congruent. They should have same size and same shape. Okay? They should have same shape and same size. Okay? But here, how you are going to say these two triangles are congruent? Okay? Actually, how you are going to draw the circles? By taking some radius, right? Okay? By taking some radius of 5 centimeters or 6 centimeters. Suppose you have drawn the circle here by taking 2 centimeters radius, and here also 2 centimeters radius. Then what happened here? Both the radiuses are same. Radius, sorry, not radius, radii. Both the radii are same. So, then we can say that the two circles are congruent. How you can say these two circles are congruent? The radii are equal. If the radii are equal, means single means radius. If the radius are equal in both, here radius, the both the radiuses are equal, then we can call these two circles are congruent. But coming to our topic, that is triangles, how you can say the two triangles are congruent. For this, we have four properties. What are those four properties? Side, side, side. By seeing the sides of a triangle. And here, side, angle, side. Side, angle, side. Here, two sides and one angle. By seeing that. And ASA. Two angles and one side. So, first I am going to explain these three. And later, right hypotenuse side. Okay? Because right hypotenuse side means we have complete figure is different. That is nothing but right angle triangle. That means we have to compare only right angle triangle this one. That's why first I will tell you 1, 2 and 4th one. Okay. So now I have drawn ABC is one triangle and PQR is one triangle. In the previous triangles chapter I told you if I keep like this a line AB and here one more line, that means what? AB side and PQ side are equal. Okay. Here I will keep here 2, here I will keep here 2. That means BC and QR are equal. And if I will keep 3 here, AC and PR are equal. So this is the way how you can compare the two triangles, okay, if they give the figure. If not, by using these properties, okay, see now, here AB is given, that means AB, just simply I am writing here, AB equals to, why, because I gave in here, this and this are equal, AB equals to PQ, that means what, side, next, BC equals to QR. I am comparing these two triangles. BC equals to QR. That is also side. And next, AC equals to PR. AC equals to PR. That is also side. If you clearly observe here, SSS, that means all are sides. Means here this side equals to this side. BC side equals to QR. AC side equals to PR. Means all sides are equal here. So compare like that. That means suppose here 5 means here 5. Here 6 means here 6. Here 7 means here 7. So like that you compare the two triangles. How you compare now? This side and this side are equal. This and this are equal. This and this are equal. That means all are sides only. By SSS congruency. By SSS congruency. SSS congruency, triangle ABC, this is the symbol for congruent. See there, how I wrote the symbol for congruence here. Like parallel lines, draw like this and simply S you can write, or like this. Okay, this is the congruent symbol, okay, congruency. So, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Now, from this, you have to get this definition. Which definition? Side, side, side. They'll ask you for one more question. Okay? They'll ask you one more question. See here. I am writing this one here. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Okay? Triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. Okay, children? Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Okay? Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Okay? That means by SSS congruency, these two triangles are congruent. Then how you have to give the definition for this? Okay? For everything, we have a definition how you have to. Right, I'll tell you. No need to by heart or anything. If you observe these two triangles and you can say within a minute that you can frame an equation in easy way. See here. In a triangle, the three sides means the otherwise you just write like this. The three sides of a triangle is equal to three sides of another triangle. See here, the three sides of a triangle is equals to the three sides of another triangle. Then the two triangles are congruent. That is which property? SSSS property, because all sides are equal. Okay, but how you have to tell SAS? Okay, just take this only an example. SAS. Okay, SAS. That means here two sides and one angle. Okay, two sides and one angle here. How we have to see the second one, second property? Okay, how we have to tell the second property? Here I am telling you. Consider same again ABC, one triangle. Okay, and another one PQR. Okay, here I gave you which property now? Side angle side. That means here two sides are equal. This side and this side and this side here. And one angle, any one angle. Okay, this is the angle. That means see here A and here AB line and PQ line are equal, and BC and QR are equal. Okay, that means AB equals to PQ. That is what side. So simply I am writing S. Next, BC equals to QR. That is also side. Now here angle B equals to angle Q. So you can write that one as A, because it is an angle. Because it is an angle. So two sides and one angle. Okay, that's why how they ask you question. Compare these two triangles and tell which property. That means AB equals to PQ side, BC equals to QR is side, angle B equals to angle Q is an angle. Okay, therefore by SAS congruency, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. By which congruency? SAS. By SAS congruency, those two triangles are congruent. Okay, by SAS congruency, those two triangles are congruent. But how we are going to say the definition for this triangle property, SAS property? In a triangle, two sides and one angle. In a triangle, two sides and one angle is equals to two sides and one angle of another triangle. Is it clear? In a triangle, two sides and one angle is equals to two sides and one angle of another triangle. Then the two triangles are said to be congruent. Okay? Is it clear? So that is what SAS congruency. Now the last one, that is angle side angle, that is ASA property. Okay, ASA property. Okay, now see here, ASA property means okay, see here the same triangle I am considering. ASA, that means one side compulsory. So this side and this side are equal. Okay, and here one angle and here one more angle. Okay, see here, this side here I given a clue here. This means this BC equals to QR. That means BC equals to QR. Okay, BC equals to QR. BC equals to QR. Next, angle B equals to angle Q. Angle C equals to angle R. That means here this is side, this is angle, and this is angle. That means angle side angle. ASA congruency. Okay, understood? ASA congruency. Okay, then how you are going to tell this definition? In a triangle, one side and two angles of a triangle is equals to one side and two angles are equal in another triangle, then the two triangles are said to be congruent. Okay, so that is ASA congruency. Okay, children, is it clear now? Okay, so today you just listen the class, and this is not the exact starting of this, because congruency I should tell you, as I told you that how, what is congruency now. Congruency means what? Two plane figures are said to be congruent. They should have same shape and same size. Okay, is it clear? So in the next class we are going to go for the exercises, and we will finish up as soon as possible. Okay, as much early as possible we will finish the chapter. Okay, after this we have two more chapters, that is comparing quantities, comparing the ratios or something, and one more, that is perimeter and area, right? That is nothing but mensuration. Okay children, have a nice day and understand the concept well. If you want, you just listen 2-3 times, you can understand very nicely, children, and very important topic also. Have a nice day.